today. The bestower of divine intellect. And the bestower of spiritual language and vision. Babdada. Is seeing the children from everywhere. Who have received a divine intellect. At the moment of Brahman birth, each Brahman child received both of these blessings. You have received a divine intellect and spiritual vision as your birthright. These blessings are the foundation of Brahman life. The attainment of these two is known as Brahman life, life transformation, or dying alive. The attainment of these two is known as Brahman life, life transformation, or dying alive.
जीवन।
The difference between your past life and present Brahman life.
अंतर। इन दो बातों का ही विशेष
is particularly based on these two aspects. The number for the effort makers of the confluence age is based on these two things. To the extent that you use both of these constantly in your every thought, word and action, to that extent, you claim a number ahead. By having spiritual vision, your attitude and actions are automatically transformed. With the divine intellect,
Swayamprata, Sevaprata, Brahman, Parivarke.
Your decisions are always made accurately. and automatically in every situation for yourself, for service and for relationships. And connections in the Brahman family. When you make an accurate decision with your divine intellect, on the basis of that decision, yourself, service, and your relationships and connections become accurate and powerful. The main things are your vision and your divine intellect. Today, Bab Dada, today, Bab Dada was checking the divine intellect of all the children. The first sign
Divya Bodhi.
The first sign of a soul having a divine intellect is that
Sada.
The soul will recognize the Father, the Self, and each Brahman soul as they are and what they are. And will constantly continue to attain the right to take from the Father. As much as he wants through that form. He will continue to attain that right. The soul will recognize the self with regard to what Baba has made him. The service for which he has been made an instrument to do. The specialities and divine virtues of Brahman life that Baba has given him. And the role for which Baba has made him an instrument. And he will make himself move accordingly, move forward accordingly. Along with that, the Brahman souls, based on the divine virtues of Brahmins, and identify the capability of that instrument. And the pace of the effort that he makes. For each six souls to understand him, what he is and how he is, understanding him accurately. Identifying those Brahman souls as they are and what they are and making them move forward. This is called knowing the Father, the Self and Brahman souls as they are and what they are and making them move forward. This is the first recognition of a divine intellect. A divine intellect means
Arthat. Holy Hansvati.
A divine intellect means a holy swan intellect. A swan means cleanliness. It means to differentiate between milk and water, or pearls and pebbles. And to imbibe the pearls. It knows which one is a pebble and which one is a pearl.
Kankar
but does not imbibe the pebbles. That is why
Holy Hans.
A holy swan.
Sangam Yogi. Jnana Swarupa Vidya Devi.
Is shown as the vehicle of the confluence-aged goddess of knowledge, Saraswati, the embodiment of knowledge. All of you are embodiments of knowledge. That is why you are the lords and goddesses of knowledge. This vehicle is a sign of divine intellect. All of you Brahmins. With the help of your intellects, in yoga, you travel around the three worlds. The intellect is also called as a vehicle. The vehicle of an intellect is the fastest of all vehicles. A divine intellect is also called the power of the intellect. Because it is only with the power of your intellect that you are able to catch all the powers from the Father. That's why it is called the power of your intellect. Just as there is the power of science.
Science power.
The power of science. Shows so many limited wonders. Many things. That people today find impossible science demonstrates to be possible. However, that is temporary power. Whereas
science be buddhi bal hai, lekin divya buddhi bal nahi.
Whereas other is the power of intellect. Science works with the power of intellect, but not the power of divine intellect. It is a worldly intellect. And it is therefore and is therefore only able to think about and work for this world and matter. the power of divine intellect. Makes you a master, almighty authority. And brings you
Paramatam Milan. Paramatam Prapti.
And brings you the recognition of God, a meeting with God. And the experience of attainments from God. Whatever you want and however you want it, a divine intellect will make the impossible possible. By having a divine intellect,
Har karam mein. Paramatam. Pure touching.
By having a divine intellect, you can experience God's pure touching, love.
Anubhavkar.
In every deed you do. And experience success in those. A divine intellect.
Go
a divine intellect can defeat any attack from Maya. Where there is a touching from the Supreme, a pure touching, where there is no mixture, it is impossible for there to be a touching or attack from Maya. Let alone Maya coming, she cannot even touch you. In front of a divine intellect, Maya becomes a garland of success. It does not remain Maya. It is just like a Rajoguni. Rishi and Muni souls. Who used to calm a lion down with their power.
Shant kar dete the. Sher.
The lion would become their companion, it would become their vehicle and their toy, because it had been transformed. So,
Sato Pardhan Master
Sarvashakti. So you who are Sato Pradhan, Master, Almighty Souls, who are blessed with the divine intellects, what is
Maya again?
What is Maya in front of you? Can Maya not be changed from being an enemy? The power of a divine intellect. Is an extremely elevated power. Simply use it. Use it in the right way according to the time and total success will be in the palms of your hands. Success is not a big thing. It simply comes from the cleanliness of your divine intellects. Just as magicians of today show the cleanliness of their palms, so the cleanliness of your divine intellects bring total success into the palms of your hands. all of you Brahmin souls? Have attained total success. And the divine success, it's not ordinary. That is right. That's why even today, devotees go in front of your image in order to attain success. It is because you became embodiments of success that devotees go to ask you for things. So did you understand what the wonder of a divine intellect is? Has the wonder of the divine intellect become clear? However, what did Baba see today? What would Baba have seen?
Teachers, sunao, kya dekha honga?
Teachers speak.
Sabhi teachers hath uthao, jo center sambhalte hai, hath uthao.
All teachers raise your hands. Those who have understood, raise your hands. Pandavs too. Half the class are teachers. You have become instruments for service, and so you have special responsibilities. What would Baba have seen? Teachers speak.
master singhyam ko gayi na.
Your teachers have become master teachers like the father, have you not? A teacher means
sankalap bol or har sekan seva mein upasthit.
A teacher means one who is engaged in doing service in every thought or word at every second. Only such a server would be called a teacher.
Har samay vani dwara seva nahi kar sakte ho to thak jayenge.
You cannot serve with words at every moment. But you can serve with your features all the time. There's no question of getting tired in that. You can do that, can you not? Teachers can only serve with words according to their capacity and according to the time. However, your features should be those of future angels. Angels are the future of the confluence age. When this is visible in your features, such good service will take place. Since your non-living images even in the last birth are doing service, doing service through their features, then you living elevated souls can easily do service with your features. Let your features Let your features constantly have the sparkle of constant happiness, peace, and joy. No matter how unhappy a soul is, how peaceless or troubled he is, let him be able to make his future elevated from your features. You have experienced this, have you not? Check your features at Amritvela.
Jaise sharir ke features ko check karte ho na.
Just as you check the features of your bodies. In the same way, check that
Koshika Shantika Sukaka Shringar Thik hai.
Check that the makeup of happiness, peace, and joy in your angelic features are all right. Check this, and service will easily and automatically continue to take place. Do you teachers find this easy? You can do this service for 12 hours. You would be able to serve with words only. For 2 to 4 hours, when you carry out the work of planning and giving lectures, you get tired. There's no question of becoming tired in this. It is natural, is it not? All of you are experienced. However, why do you laugh when Bhaktada says, however? Bhaktada has seen. That in some foreign lands, people keep many dogs and cats as pets. And you bring such toys here. You have many good experiences, but sometimes a dog or a cat enters. And you take time to chase it away. It comes quickly, but it takes time for you to chase it away. However, you were told today that Maya Maya will become a garland of success.
Sabhi nimit sevadari ke gale mein mala pari hui hai.
There is a garland around the neck of all the instrument servers. Is there a garland of success? Do you have a garland of success? Is it yes or no? Or is it that although the garland is around your neck, you sometimes do not see it? You search outside for success. You tell the story of Queen who had necklace around her neck, and yet she was searching for it outside. You do not do this, do you? Success is the right of every Brahmin soul. Are all of you teachers are embodiments of success, are you not? Or are you embodiments of effort and embodiments of labor? Efforts should be easy efforts, not laborious efforts. The definition of accurate effort is natural attention. The definition of accurate effort is natural attention. Some say we have to pay attention, but they do not know when attention changes into tension.
Natural attention,
natural attention means to be an accurate effort maker. You are effort maker, that is good, but are you an accurate effort maker?
Suna teachers ne, suna, suna.
Bab Dada loves the teachers and he therefore does not allow them to labor. This is the love of the heart, is it not? Achcha. Next time, you will be told of what else Baba saw. He will tell a little at a time. All of you are able to see your own picture, are you not? There is great splendor of service done in this land and in the foreign lands. And the conference in Bharat was very successful. The sign of success is that the number the sign of success is that the number of souls with zeal and enthusiasm is increasing because of the fragrance of success. This is the sign. A sign of something good is that there is an increasing desire in everyone to see, hear, and attain it. This is a sign of something good. So, do not think that the number will be very small. If you are doing something good, their desire will increase and the number of them will also increase. Whether it is a retreat for foreigners or a conference, day by day, the results results of both are looking good.
Sab
the best result of all is that previously in foreign lands, they used to think that no one would come because of the name of Brahma Kumaris. Now they understand. People are going to Brahma Kumaris ashram itself for a retreat and to learn Raj Yoga. You have come out from behind the curtain. The veil now has been removed. The Madhuban residents and the servers who came from all the different parts of Bharat did service. The Madhuban residents and the servers from everywhere did not consider the situation around them. They did not think about their rest, but did good, tireless service with love. That is why Bab Dada is giving congratulations to the special children from everywhere who attained success by doing tireless service. He is giving congratulations from the heart. The echoing sound is spreading in all directions. to all the souls who are blessed with divine intellects and spiritual vision. To the souls who are embodiments of knowledge and who constantly use the power of their divine intellects according to the task and the time, to the souls who constantly do service with their angelic features, and who are natural and easy effort maker souls, Bhavdadas, love, remembrance, and namaste.